Hola, bienvenidos. ¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo están?
Here, let me translate so you can understand.
My name is Sergio Alvarez. Can you guess where I am from?
I am from the land of opportunity, where I can be anything I want.
I can be the president, the chief, the commandant.
But my eyes are set on the stars.
I dream of being an astronaut.
I dream of being in Mars.
My story begins with a cyclical story
involving two immigrants with a similar story.
She headed north, escaping poverty.
He headed north in search of glory.
And there I am between my mom and dad, in my mother's arms, the little lad. I have a little brother, his name's Carlitos, but in our family we just like to call him Litos. He is almost two, and I am 5 years old now. I can even tie my shoe. I am so excited to start attending school.
Ready to be an astronaut.
It's gonna be so cool. Finally, I will learn all about the stars, solar systems, galaxies, even quasars.
Houston, we have a problem. There was a shift in the wind. My brother and I live in Mexico now. We make my abuelita's head spin. Her personality is sunny. She likes to sing silly songs that are funny. I attend school here, for I am no dummy. However, my first grade teacher is very strict. If I don't stay still and look forward, she hits me with her stick.
Houston, the winds continue shifting still. It seems the road revolves around my parents' will.
Here I am with my abuelito, my father's father, Dominguito. We now live in Puerto Barrios, Izabal, Guatemala. I go to school here, but how will it affect my amygdala?
My second grade teacher is just as strict as my last. I think they might know each other, but I do not dare to ask.
I once forgot to raise my hand, a painful memory I cannot withstand. She grabbed her meter stick and said, "A lesson you must learn, so you do not speak out of turn."
Houston, I am back. We can live in the U.S. again without feeling attacked. See, the U.S. is giving out work permits, they are giving out papers. So my mom can work at night, cleaning up skyscrapers. Yes, I am in school, but I'm not getting ahead. I'm having trouble understanding what the teacher said. Once, she pointed at me and asked if I could read. I made an attempt, but I didn't succeed. As I struggled to read, the class broke out in laughter. You will find out why I started disliking Jello thereafter. I looked toward the teacher in search of a clue, only to notice she was laughing too. After the laughter, the teacher announced, they were laughing at a color I had mispronounced. Learning English has been difficult, there's just too many rules, and I am in need of many more tools. But my ears cannot help me, this is true. I must learn to use my eyes in lieu. If I am to become an astronaut, I must pay close attention, or later risk navigating to an alternate dimension. I am learning to defend myself, just like Bruce Lee, so I can be ready for a local bully named Frankie. One of my friends was jumped by a local gang member, an ugly memory that I will always remember. Gangs were always around, shooting each other, I just dropped to the ground. My mom and dad often fight, my dad once gave my mother a bite. I once found the courage to stand in his way, but my father's fury just carried away. I made it through elementary school, but it hasn't been easy. The thought of becoming an astronaut has started to sound cheesy. I still go to the library, but just once in a while. I like to hang out by the astronomy aisle. My parents advised me to focus. They advised me to prepare. Their words sound alarming, a tone of despair. They make me feel anxious, they make me feel scared. Midway through my first week in middle school, we were held up at gunpoint by a fool. He approached us and asked where we were from. I pretended not to hear him. I kept pressing on. He caught up and stood in my way. "Empty your pockets," he demanded, "or I'll blast you away. Do as I say or things will end bad." A lunch ticket and my lucky $2 bill was all I had. He smacked me in the head and said, "Get out of here, you little nerds." But those were his choice words. But let's continue with this story. that I assure you ends in glory. So I will have 6 teachers from now on, and already my science teacher and I are not getting along. He got really angry as I interrupted his class. I didn't know how to pronounce the word pores, so I had to ask. To learn my lesson, he sent me to detention, but I like it there. No one trying to test your comprehension. Between 6th grade and 8th, I took a great leap of faith. And quite frankly, I don't know how I did it. I kept getting sent to detention. I just couldn't stay seated. I got in fights and mischievous deeds, too ashamed to mention. I guess I just needed attention, someone, anyone, to give me orientation. My 10th grade history teacher had a message he would feature. No sean mensos, he would say. Education sets the way. Mr. Castro understood me. He knew my apprehension. His family was forced back home in the 1930s. Mexican repatriation. I wasted time in high school. Actions I regret. But you try staying focused with the weapon to your head. Long story short, I just couldn't comport. My dreams of becoming an astronaut, I had to abort. No more silly dreams of alien worlds to explore. Time for cami greens, time to join the Corps.
Houston, Houston, can't you see what the Corps has done to me? I used to walk in Levi jeans, and now I'm wearing cami greens. Hoorah, Marine Corps. My first year in the Corps, my orders I couldn't ignore. I was sent to Okinawa, Japan. What a beautiful island. What beautiful land. September 11th. Oh, what a tragic day. When hijacked airplanes created dismay. The president embarked on a campaign against terrorism. The Marines were sent to show their heroism. I am now in Iraq, guarding gold that is black. I fired my weapon. I laid down a man. Emotions I do not yet understand. Why am I here? I am confused. I am astonished. Our commander-in-chief declared mission accomplished. I almost quit college before I began. An anxiety attack I couldn't command. On my first day of class, my courage ran out of gas. I couldn't step out of the car. I was thinking pessimistically. I wouldn't go far. My wife looked at me and said, "Honey, you have the opportunity that others can't. You must educate yourself. You can't recant." Houston, I am proud to report that I have a new mission. I am a healer, an educator, a mathematician. My experience has given me strength. My experience has given me vision. I fight the good fight to abolish systemic submission. We navigate through a digital dimension filled with nonsensical discrimination. I remind my students, you have one hand to help yourselves. You have one hand to help another. Be kind, caring citizens who uplift each other. Their mental health is my priority, to send them off to college, the majority. I navigate with empathy for those I cross like me, who are English language learners too, who don't feel free to be. I will break the chains of oppression with my newfound profession. I will educate, I will inspire, and I will bring awareness to any systemic unfairness so that my children and students can go to Mars
in case they set their eyes on the stars. We have now reached the end of this story that I assured you in slide 12 ends in glory. Thank you.